Now, the name game is often used in relation to puppies and puppy training, but realistically, it can be used with any dog of any age. This will actually be the basis that we're going to use for our recall command. Now, in the beginning, we're going to be doing this with no distractions. As you can see here, it's just me and the dog and a very long leash. If you have a backyard, obviously you don't need the leash, but it does offer an extra barrier of security, especially when we're first introducing the name game. In case they get a little bit distracted and you're too far away, you can grab that leash and just give it a small little tug. Not enough to actually move them, but just enough to let them know that you're there, and then you give them that praise, love, and attention. As you can see, I'm tossing a treat onto the ground somewhere around him, and when he gets distracted by it and starts to focus on it, that's when I run back and I call him to me. I'm gonna say his name, I'm gonna be very, very excited, and when he gets to me, I'm gonna ask him to sit down, and I'm gonna give him that love, attention, praise, those treats if I have them, if I'm utilizing them. Treats will be your best friend for the name game. We do eventually want to phase them out, yes, but in the beginning, we want this to be a fun game where he goes, ignores the distraction, and realizes if he comes to you, good things happen. That's ultimately going to be the basis for really any sort of outdoor activities, which is that we want the dog to find us more appealing and more exciting and more attractive than anything else in the environment. So when I throw that treat on the ground and I take a couple of steps back, I'm gonna be as excited as possible. If he does have a little bit of difficulty in the beginning, what I'm gonna do is when he gets to me, I'm gonna jackpot him. I'm gonna give him 3, 4, 5 treats in a row. I'm gonna let him know this is the greatest thing that he possibly could have done. Once you see that the dog is really starting to get it, and that's going to be completely dependent upon you and your dog and how often you practice. But once they start to get it with no distractions, that's when you can start adding in small distractions. For this particular video, you'll see that we have Zira, the 10-pound miniature pincher. She's running around in circles. She's actually doing the name game with Loki in this video, but I'm not asking her to. I didn't stop her because I wanted her to be that distraction. And at one point, if you watch, he does get distracted and he slows down and comes to a stop somewhere halfway in the middle. If that should happen, which is what we want those distractions because we can't tell the dog what to do right if they never do anything wrong. So we do want them to be distracted. And if he gets distracted, like in this video, what I'm going to do is be even more over the top. I want to be even more excited when I call him. I'm going to clap my hands. I'm going to stomp my feet. I'm going to be as exciting as possible. I'm going to keep upping that excitement until I get his focus and attention. Once he comes back to me, then I'm going to give him that reward. Another important tip is, like I said before, we want to keep our excitement level up because we want this to be a game, we want it to be fun and engaging, but we want to remember that our excitement is going to come in the moment that the dog turns around. So I don't care that the dog isn't looking at me, and it's very possible with new puppies that they're starting to turn around because they noticed something else, they got distracted by a smell or something of that sort, and that's okay. Once they start to turn around, then we amp our excitement level up. Come on, come on, you can do it, let's go. So we amp our excitement level up as soon as they turn around so that we can catch that focus, get them back to us, and again, we ask them to sit down, we give them that love, praise, and attention. In the video with Loki here, in the second video, you may notice that I'm not asking him to sit down quite yet. And that's because Loki and I don't have that type of relationship yet. We're building it right now. And so what I'm asking him to do is simply come to me. Loki in particular is a very stranger danger kind of dog. And so I'm not super concerned with him sitting down just yet. I'm more concerned with him just coming to me. So, like you saw in the first video, we asked him to sit down when there were no distractions around. When there are distractions around, then it's almost like rapid fire. We're going back and forth. Loki this way, Loki this way, Loki this way. We're going back and forth, and simply trying to get him used to the idea again. Hearing his voice means come to me, and good things will happen. So, to recap, the name game is going to be the foundation that we're going to use for our recall. And though oftentimes we're going to see it associated with puppies, it really can be used with any dog of any age. And the most important aspect of the name game, whether you're using a puppy or an adult dog, is that we want to keep our excitement level up, and we also want to match their intensity with our excitement. So if the dog is super distracted by something, we want to make sure that we are super exciting. If you are starting off with distractions, then maybe if your dog is a little bit easily distracted by things, you could start off with a high value treat, a high value reward, something that they only get for the name game. Again, this is going to be our foundation for the recall command. So we want to practice this as much as possible. Even if you already have a new dog, practice it as much as possible so that later on we can start incorporating that and transitioning that into a nice solid recall command. So thanks for watching this video on the name game. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave them in the comments section below. Don't forget to smash that like button. Don't forget to click that red subscribe button. And as always, join me on this journey of some minor dog training where I teach you how to train yourself to better train your dogs.